back to Life in Pixels. Thanks so much for joining me. Today, I just wanted to give a quick little video tutorial on how to set custom aging in The Sims 4 using MC Command Center. So, a lot of people I've seen recently on Twitter and Facebook talk about their frustrations on the age span settings in The Sims 4, how you can't really customize them as much as you could in some of the previous versions of the game. And I know personally, one of my biggest gripes is that I feel the aging is so unbalanced in The Sims 4. Often, like even if you have your young adult Sim have a child pretty early on in their life, that now your Sim is an elder when their child is still a teenager, and then of course they don't live to be able to see their grandchildren and stuff, so it's pretty annoying. But I have a fix with that using MC Command Center. So if we just go into our regular gameplay settings, just to show you real quick, that if you go into game options, over here to gameplay, you can set your Sim's lifespan between short, normal, and long, and that changes the overall amount of days of their normal life. And I find that normal, like I said, is unbalanced. It's kind of short, but long is just way too long for my personal taste. And I don't want to play with aging off because I like the other Sims around me to age up too. So like I said, I use MC Command Center, which is a common mod that a lot of people have, but it's really complex and there's a lot of different pieces to it. So a lot of people don't know how to use all the different parts in it. So if we go click on any computer in our home, we can just click, go to MC Command Center, pull up the main menu for this mod, go to this first bubble, MCC settings, and then there's this bubble here, set age span duration, and then you can set human, cat, and dog. You can tweak these to all be different. Let's look at human. And so here's all the different life stages, baby through elder, and you can set each of these to be an individual value. So let's just click on baby. It shows that the minimum value has to be 1 and the maximum value can be up to 1,000. So each life stage has to have at least 1 day in it, but no more than 1,000 days in it. And then it'll tell you what the default is for each life stage, and then you enter your own right here in this box. So it says the default for babies is 2. I left babies on 2. There's really not a lot that you do with babies. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we get a baby update at some point, but there's not much you can do with babies, so I just leave that one on 2. And then toddlers, it shows the default is 7. I just bumped that up by 1. I made it 8. Children, the default is 13 days. I gave them 16. I like to be able to complete their children aspirations, and I like to just be able to do a little bit more with children, so I just gave them a few more days. And then teen, the default is 13. And I gave them 14. I just bumped it up by 1 more day, just to kind of make it even. And the reason that I didn't add too much more to the teenagers is currently, as it stands, they can already start working towards their adult aspirations and all of their adult skills and everything. So I didn't really find it necessary to lengthen the teenage lifespan too much. If they make some updates to teenagers at some point, I might reconsider what I keep my settings at. And then young adult, the default is 24. I changed this significantly. I changed it to 35. I just like to give some more days for my young adults to pursue their careers or go do dating and stuff like that before they start having children or feel like they have to have children super young. I'm a really big family game player, so I like to have things way more balanced. So I chose to bump it up higher. And then for adults, the default is 24. I made this 45 days in total. I think that a lot of people, when in real life, when they become grandparents, a lot of people are like 45, 50, 55 years old, and they're definitely not elders. They're not somebody I would consider an elder in society for real. They're not a retirement age. They're not, you know, walking all hunched over like the elders are in The Sims. And so I want my Sims to be able to have grandchildren and maybe even great grandchildren, you know, depending on how old they were when they first became a parent. And I really like this family gameplay because I'm an adult, I'm a young adult right now, And my mom, she's still like within her adult span. She is not older yet. My grandmother is still alive. So if I'm an adult, if I'm a young adult, my grandmother is still alive. She could be considered an elder in Sims terms. I just want things to be evened out a little bit more. So that's why I bumped this up so much. And then elders, I went ahead and their default is 10 days. I gave them 20 days. I know we don't have like a ton of elder specific content to do right now, but you know, realistically, after you retire, people retire around the age of like 65. They usually live more than 10 years after that. So I wanted to give them a little bit extra. So all in all, the way I have my aging set up is my Sims, their normal lifespan is a total of 140 days. And so 45 plus 35 equals 80 days. And then plus 20 days as an elder is 100. So I give them a total of 100 days in between young adult and elder, and then a total of 40 days between baby through teenager. So that's how I kind of have mine balanced out. And I will go ahead and put my age specific settings in the description box if that's something that you want to use for yourself. So let's go ahead and look at animals. So I'm going to click on cat, and it will say child, adult, and elder. So kitten, adult cat, elder cat. And this one's a little bit different from humans. I don't know if animals have kind of a random aging to where by default it's not an exact number of days that they're like a kitten or an adult. I don't know exactly how that works, but this one, you put in a minimum and a maximum value. So it says specify the number of days in the selected age span. Value should be separated by a comma with the minimum number of days first and the maximum number of days last. And so for kittens, it says default is 1 day to 1.5 days. So I just doubled that value. I made it 2 to 3 days. For an adult cat, it says the default is between 21 and 24 days. So I just bumped that up some. I made it between 30 and 35 days. And then for an elder cat, it says between 6 and 8 days. I made it between 8 and 10. So I just wanted to give, I didn't change it a lot, but I wanted to give it a little bit more age for both cats and dogs since I have my humans living longer. And then for dogs, again, child, adult, elder. So I think it's the same values. Yeah. So for puppies, it would be between 1 and 1.5 days. Again, I changed it to 2 and 3. Adult dogs, between 17 and 20 days. I changed it to be between 25 and 30 days. And then for elder dogs, it says between 5 and 7. I changed it from that to 7 to 9 days. So again, I will put these values in the description so that you can use my settings if you want to, but that's it. That's all you have to do to create custom aging in The Sims 4 using MC Command Center. So I hope this was helpful, and I will talk to y'all next time. Bye.